how to edit very red looking eyebrows, and which applications I use to beautify my photos, you will see in this video. And as always, welcome to So the first application that you're going to need is Lightroom. In this application, we will remove the redness, but unfortunately, not only from eyebrows, but from everywhere. But later, we will bring the color back to the skin and lips. So when you open the Lightroom, just press the color. After the color, press color mix. Here, we're going to target red color because the red color we want to neutralize. So press the red color and then play around with the first hue. You can bring more red if you want to, or more brown color. And then with saturation, you can also bring the saturation down to remove maybe the brown colors from the brows. Now you can see that the lips, the skin, everything got neutralized. So that's something we will bring back with our next application. And by the way, if you play around with this, it's basically lighten up or darkens everything. All right, so go ahead and save this picture. Now, regardless of the second application, there are two ways how you can edit this picture further. One is my more favorite way, another is least favorite. So the first way is Beauty Plus. With the Beauty Plus, I will just add the makeup on top. I will fix the skin and bring the color back on her lips, eyes, just using makeup. The other way, the second way, sounds like more useful way, but I still prefer the first one. You will see why. So the other way is just cut out the brows from our new edited photo and paste it on original. So it will just look like we only fixed the brows, which is true. So let's see the difference between two ways. Go ahead and open your Beauty Plus. So if your picture is reversed, sometimes the makeup wouldn't work or some applications wouldn't work. So you want to kind of turn it to the normal position, rotate it. And then we will first work on the skin and then work on the makeup and brows, because what I like about Beauty Plus, you can really edit the skin so nicely. And the first step is going to be acne. So that's something that will just naturally fix the skin, instantly fix the skin. This is like really great way to just very naturally edit the photo without even noticing it's being edited. So I do start with that first, but then the second step, it's more glamorous way to edit the skin. It's HD retouch. So it's just going to make the skin very flawless looking, like for magazine, picture from magazine. Some people like this look, some people don't. I actually do like the effect from HD retouch. And after that, I can also add smoothness to the skin just because I like the look of such photos. And you can see how smooth the skin becomes. After that, you can also add smoothness to the skin. This is like extra super smooth for people who like very smooth. I personally just maybe press a little bit on that, and then that's about it. Now, next step is bringing back the brightness to the eyes. That's so important because the picture looks way better if you are going to brighten the eyes. And I also love to use whiten effect. Usually that's for teeth, but I always use this for the eyes, because this is going to further brighten the eye. Sometimes if we have a redness on the eye, it also can neutralize the redness and bring the brightness. Just add here, maybe more. It just gives this nice dimension to the eyes. And also you can use this under the brow, just to kind of really bring the shape to brow. So you can see the eyes are already now like sparkling. Very nice. After this, our model is still look very pale. So how do we fix it? while we need to go to makeup. And a lot of you will not like this step. That's why the second way how to edit picture might mostly work for you. I do like it. I'm just basically bringing the life to my model just using the makeup on her pale lips. And somehow it's just a faster way, in my opinion. So something like this, then I add a blush a little bit, I add a contour. Next, by the way, this is really funny, I just discovered this. If you press the first one, actually you can see that it brings back the color to eyebrows. So right now they were just a little bit too disappearing. So you can add the color, the darkness back to the brows, which is nice. I'm not sure though how I can see the brown color. Okay, I can see all other colors. So bringing the darkness to the brows is really nice. Yeah, I think now the picture look really good in my opinion. I'm not sure how you like it, but I feel it's like really kind of magazine type. And to compare this, because I need to bring this back, if I just do like this, can't really compare. So I'm just going to show you by bringing this back, and let's see the difference before, after. Before, after. Wow, that's amazing. She's not pale anymore. Wow. All right, so this is the first way, and now I'm going to show you the second way how you can edit, remove the redness from eyebrows. So do you remember we first removed the redness from the whole face, and now using a snapseed, we are going to cut everything else except the brows. So first go ahead and open your original photo, the one that has very red eyebrows. And then on top of that, you're going to put a new edited photo in Lightroom, after Lightroom. So press double exposure and add picture on top. Now, right now it still look red because actually opacity here is half. So you need to bring opacity to 100%. Remember this, otherwise it just look like why the eyebrows are still red. So bring opacity to 100% and then 100% the new photo will cover your old photo and hit OK. Now go to layers and view edits. Over here, you will see the layer with double exposure. Press this and hit edit. And now you just need to walk with your finger on the brow itself to bring our new, what we edited on top of this. And you can see that if you see, I just put it on top of the eyebrows and you see that the redness just disappeared from eyebrows because I didn't touch the skin or any other parts of the face. So that's it. That's the step. Of course, from here, you can further edit the skin using Beauty Plus and repeat all the steps, the same steps. It's all up to you. So I hope you like these tips. I really find them useful. I edit all my photos using this way. Of course, right now we do have a professional editors, but I honestly feel that these applications look as good as somebody professional who would retouch this photo because you know where to focus your attention on, and now you know how to edit the picture. I hope you like this video, and I hope you are waiting for my next week new video coming on Beauty/website, and I'll see you next week. And off the record, editing pictures do take a lot of time. So at first, of course, you would use your own time, but later when you will be occupied with clients, I do suggest to hire a photo editor as it will just free up your time so much. And also share with me once you try to edit your pictures, if there's any new things you uncover or want to share with me, just go ahead and do so. My email is ask@beauty/.com. And again, see you next week. And remember to check out the PDF under this video, just the link under this video on how to edit photos like a pro.